The three biggest heroes I have in the music industry are probably Berry Gordy of Motown and two men who are with us now. They are producer-composers of the genius mold. You hardly ever see these two because they're usually very busy doing just that. We'd like for you to meet them and see them because their music will probably be with you for as long as you live. Their names are synonymous with such names as the OJs, Lou Rawls, Teddy Pendergrass, TSOP. They invented the sound of Philadelphia. They are the founders of Philadelphia International Records, and they have a whole lot of money. Let's welcome Kenny Gamble and Leon Huff. So, what brings you fellows to Los Angeles, which has always been a very hard thing to do, bring you away from Philadelphia?
We came to Los Angeles to attend a convention with CBS Records, and stopped by Soul Train. It's you.
It's really a delight to have you here. You having a good time, Leon?
Yeah, really, really good time. I feel good about being here because like Soul Train dancers like give us sort of inspiration to set these grooves because to me they revolutionized the whole dance, you know, throughout the whole country. So it's a pleasure for me to even be inside, you know, behind the scenes to see it.
That's a very nice compliment. Okay. Now, as a team, I've heard the story. You were singing in a singing group, right?
Well, trying to sing, just a little bit, not much.
They tell you still try.
When we write and things like that. But
I see. Yeah. But you've been together how long?
We've been together about 17 years, 16, 17 years.
You know, Kenny, you're a relatively young man. You're 34, and to a lot of people, that's very young.
Yes.
I mean, especially to me.
Right, yeah, exactly. Very young.
That's very young. So you started in what year?
I started when I was about 18.
About 18 years old.
Which is really professionally about 18.
Uh-huh.
And I used to sing and write songs while I was in school also, too. So my first recording was when I was about 17 or 18. Mm-hmm. For a guy named Freddie Cannon, who was a long time ago, Everybody Monkey or something like that, you know.
Didn't you and Huff used to write or produce for somebody and they didn't pay you very much and you decided you'd do it for yourselves?
Exactly. Yeah, that's exactly what happened.
And that's like,
well, we started out as writers and we used to take our songs to different producers and they were supposedly to interpret the songs, you know, and record them like we heard the songs. And we found that we were basically telling them how the song was supposed to go. And that was the producer's job, so we started to produce after that, you know.
Yeah, that was a very clever idea. Mm-hmm. Paid off a little bit, huh?
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
I mean, you made a few bucks, right, Kenny?
Right, well, you know, there's nothing wrong with money. There's nothing wrong with money.
You're doing a great thing, both of you now, along with Ed Wright. You founded the Black Music Association. Tell us a little bit about that.
The Black Music Association is an organization that is being built to sustain and perpetuate black music in America as a culture of the black people in America, because there are many people who like to take black music and call it their own. And we have no type of an organization that is put together in order to raise the mentality and the awareness on an international level of the greatness of black music and all the black artists that need to be tributed for their, their contribution to American music.
It's something I think has been needed for a long time. I'd like to congratulate both of you,
thank you,
as well as Ed Wright for, shall we say, putting it together.